குட் ஈவினிங் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ். ஸோ இப்போ வந்து நான் வந்து பிஹெச்பி ஸ்கிரிப்டு எப்படி வந்து சாம்ப் சர்வரில் ரன் பண்ணுறதுன்ற டெமோ காமிக்கிறேன். இது அப்படியே வீடியோ பார்த்து நீங்கள் அப்படியே உங்களுடைய லேப்டாப்லேயோ இல்லை சிஸ்டத்துலேயோ நீங்கள் ட்ரை பண்ணிங்கன்னா உங்களுக்கு லேர்ன் பண்ணுறதுக்கு ஈஸியாக இருக்குன்ற ஈஸியாக நீங்கள் லேர்ன் பண்ணிக்கலாம். இப்போ டெமோ வந்து பார்க்கலாம். So XAMPP server or XAMPP server, it is a free and open source. Open source na vandu you can download it from the net and you can directly use it. So adha vandu open source concept. So enna pannona neenga vandu you have to download XAMPP server first. So adhukku enna pannona Google poyitu எக்ஸாம்பிள்னு டைப் பண்ணணும். எக்ஸாம்பிள்னா ஸோ ஏ ஃபார் அப்பாச்சி, எம் ஃபார் மரியாடிபி, மரியாடிபி இஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் த டேட்டா பேஸ், பி ஃபார் பிஹெச்பி அண்ட் அனதர் பி ஃபார் பர்ல். ஸோ இதில் ஃபஸ்ட் லிங்கே அப்பாச்சி ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் டாட் ஓஆர்ஜின்னு இருக்குது. அதில் போயிட்டு நீங்கள் ஜாம்ப் இன்ஸ்டாலர் அண்ட் டவுன்லோட் ஃபார் அப்பாச்சி ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ்னு சொல்லிட்டு இருக்குது. நீங்கள் இந்த டவுன்லோட் லிங்கை கிளிக் பண்ணலாம், இல்லைன்னா இந்த வெப்சைட் லிங்கை கிளிக் பண்ணுங்கள். ஸோ இங்கே பார்த்தீங்கன்னா வாட் இஸ் ஜாம்ப். ஜாம்ப் இஸ் த மோஸ்ட் பாப்புலர் பிஹெச்பி டெவலப்மெண்ட் என்விரான்மெண்ட். ஜாம்ப் இஸ் எ கம்ப்ளீட்லி ஃப்ரீ, ஈஸி டு இன்ஸ்டால் அப்பாச்சி டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூஷன் கண்டெய்னிங் மரியாடிபி, பிஹெச்பி அண்ட் பர்ல். த ஜாம்ப் ஓப்பன் சோர்ஸ் பேக்கேஜ் ஹஸ் பின் செட்டப் டு பி இன்க்ரெடிபிளி ஈஸி டு இன்ஸ்டால் அண்ட் டு யூஸ். ஸோ இதில் வந்து டவுன்லோட்ஸ் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, ஸோ ஜாம்ப் ஃபார் விண்டோஸ், ஜாம்ப் ஃபார் லினக்ஸ், ஜாம்ப் ஃபார் ஓஎஸ்ன்னு இருக்குது. ஸோ இதில் நீங்கள் வந்து ஜாம்ப் ஃபார் விண்டோஸை கிளிக் பண்ணுங்கள். கிளிக் பண்ணிவிட்டு ஸோ கிளிக் பண்ணதும் யூ கேன் சி இட் இஸ் டவுன்லோடிங் இட் ஹியர். யூ கேன் சி இன் த லெஃப்ட் ஹேண்ட் சைட் ஜாம்ப் சர்வர் இஸ் டவுன்லோடிங். இது டவுன்லோட் ஆகிட்டுருக்கு. ஸோ அதே மாதிரி உங்களுக்கு லேம்ப் வேணும், இல்லை வேறு ஆப்ரேட்டிங் சிஸ்டமில் நீங்கள் ரன் பண்ணணுன்னாக்கா அது கரஸ்பாண்டிங்காக நீங்கள் டவுன்லோட்ஸில் போயிட்டு நீங்கள் அதை பார்த்து எது உங்களுக்கு தேவையோ அதை எடுத்துக்கணும். ஸோ இஃப் யூ சி த சைஸ், ஸோ இட் இஸ் ஒன்லி 156 MB. ஸோ இட் ஆக்குபைஸ் வெரி லெஸ் மெமரி. ஸோ யூ கேன் டவுன்லோட் இட் அண்ட் யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி எக்ஸிக்யூட் யுவர் பிஹெச்பி ஸ்கிரிப்ட் யூஸிங் த ஜாம் சர்வர். ஸோ யூ நோ வெரி வெல் பிஹெச்பி இஸ் ஏ ஓப்பன் சோர்ஸ் அண்ட் இட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ ஏ சர்வர் சைட் ஸ்கிரிப்டிங் லாங்குவேஜ். So now it is downloading, so only 3 minutes is left. So XAMPP for Linux is here, so XAMPP for OS X, and you can see the previous versions of the download in the download link. So you can see here version 7.2.3, then version 7.3.21, version 7.4.9. so you can download the latest version. So all these things, similarly XAMPP for Linux, so Linux version, so you have 7.2.33, 7.3.21, 7.4.9. So for iOS, XAMPP for OS X, so you can have different version. And once it is downloaded, it will be creating a control panel. where you can start different services like PHP, MySQL, everything will be stored in a control panel. So once it is successfully downloaded, we have to install this particular thing to our system. So I am waiting for the download to be completed. So you can work with PHP using WAM server as well as XAM server. So it is depends upon the user to decide which web server they are going to work. So if you are comfortable with the XAM, you can easily work with XAM. Or if you are comfortable with the WAM server, you can work with the WAM server. So now almost our execution this thing downloading is over. You can see the folder. So just click show in folder. So this is the XAMPP Windows 64 10.4.9. So installer, you just click that particular application. Executable file. Now we are going to download the XAMPP server in our system. Do you want to allow this app to make changes to your device? Yes, click yes. In cases this may slow down your interfere and the installation of the software. So antivirus run aagumbodhu process vandha the slow down solli solranga. Continue with the installation, you have to give yes. So just click OK. So this is how it is starting up the your installation process. Setup XAMPP, welcome to the XAMPP setup wizard. So just click next. So leave everything as it is. So if you want to select some components only to be installed in the system, you can select it. So otherwise you can just click next. So you have to select the folder or in the which place you want to download the XAMPP server. So you have to select. By default it is showing C colon XAMPP folder. So just click next. So the selected folder is not empty. Please select a different folder, because I already have that particular folder. So what I am going to do is I have to remove that particular folder, then I have to change it. So here you can see already I have XAMPP folder. So now I have to remove that XAMPP folder. So you can see WAM folder here. Now again I have to continue my installation. C colon XAMPP folder, just click next. And you have to select in language. XAMPP control panel for Windows supports different languages. So it is showing English and Dutch. So you select English and click next. Now just click next. So now the setup is showing the website and you can click next. Now the XAMPP server is installing in your machine. So this XAMPP server is containing different packages like PHP, MySQL, Apache. So it has containing different packages. So one thing you should remember, when some web server is running your machine, you have to stop, then you have to start that particular server. Suppose I want to work with XAMPP server, means make sure that in the control panel you have the local services option. There you need to go and stop other services which are utilizing the particular thing. That is, if the other IAS or some other web server is running, you have to stop that particular web server, then only you have to start the current web server which you want to work with. So the very first thing is you have to initialize the services of the particular XAMPP server. So initially I want to start the services of Apache in MySQL by clicking the start button in the control panel. Once this installation is over, the XAMPP server will create the control panel in your system. So it is giving all the information, creating uninstaller. So it is installing. Everything is going very perfectly. Then after that, it will create the control panel. Now you can see the message, completing the XAMPP setup wizard. Setup has finished the installing XAMPP on your computer. Do you want to start the control panel now? So you can give finish. You can see the control panel now. So this is nothing but the control panel. As I said earlier, it has got different models or different services under the XAMPP control panel. That is Apache. So to work with the PHP, you have to start the Apache web server, Apache module. Then MySQL, to work with MySQL database, you have to start this particular MySQL. FileZilla, to work with your web application, like hosting, making changes, everything, you have to go for FileZilla. Then you have Tomcat, this is also a web server, and you have Mercury also here. So we are going to concentrate only Apache and MySQL, which is going to use for PHP and MySQL to be executed using the XAMPP server. So you just click the start button. Now attempting to start Apache app, status change detected, that is running. So similarly, you just click MySQL and also you click the start button for MySQL. So again, you are getting the message here. So attempting to start MySQL app, status change is detected, that is running. So you should remember, now the PHP and MySQL both are running because I have clicked the start button. These two services are running. So after that, what we have to do is we have to download the Notepad++ editor. So Notepad plus editor, which will be very, very much useful for developing developing or writing the script. So it makes the users writing the coding process will be very easy if you are using this thing Notepad++, because it shows the keywords and it shows the functions in different colors, and also it shows the line number. So you will find out where exactly the error you have to find out the particular error line number. You can find out very easily using this particular Notepad++. So what I am going to do now, go to the file option, go to the new option. So I am just typing a simple PHP script, that is ?PHP, then echo welcome to XAMPP server. So again, I am having another statement. So print, both echo and print, it is used to print some string to be displayed in the web page. So I am including break tag here. So print break tag, and you can have some text messages, all the variables. So this is a simple script and question mark greater than symbol. So less than symbol, question mark, PHP is the delimiter. We used to say delimiter, or similar like our HTML. This is your starting tag and this is your end tag, question mark greater than symbol. As you all very well know that we don't have any compiler to compile these scripts. So browser is acting as a compiler. By seeing the very first line or delimiter, the browser will understand the code after this less than symbol, question mark, PHP. It is meant for PHP. And once it is executing all the instruction, so when it is seeing question mark greater than symbol, that means the PHP code end with this particular line. So once you have finishing the writing the code, so you have to save the script. So go to the save option and you have to save the file in a perfect place. So where you need to save? So you have to save it in a folder called XAMPP. Under the XAMPP, you have one more folder called htdocs. So hypertext documents. So under that, you have to create working directory or virtual directory for yourself. So I need to create a folder under the htdocs. So just click new folder option and I am creating a folder with my name, Anand. Once I have created the folder and double click that particular thing, and after that you have to give test.php. So you can have the file extension for PHP is PHP. So PHP is hypertext preprocessor, and in other WAMP server we used to save it as all files. Here you just click option P, it will show the file types of your PHP hypertext preprocessor file, star.php, star.ph3, star.ph4, star.ph5, and you can also save the PHP file as star.phtml. That is also you can give. Once you have saved as type hypertext preprocessor file, and you can give here test.php. So no need to mention also. So better you used to give the file extension test.php. Just click save. So once you are saving this thing, then after that what you have to do is go to the web browser, open a new browser. So this is how you have to execute your PHP script. So I am going to open a new browser. What you have to do is, in WAMP we used to type the URL for running the web server, http localhost. This is a procedure we are following in WAMP. XAMPP or XAMPP, you have to follow the same procedure, http://localhost, followed by the folder name which you have created under the c:\htdocs. After that, you are having your working directory or virtual directory. Name of that working directory or virtual directory which I have given is anand. So this is how you have to execute your PHP script. So this is a folder which I have created. So XAMPP folder. Under that XAMPP, you can have htdocs. Under that, you have created your own working directory, that is Anand. So now you can see the file here, test.php. So what I have to do is just go here, index of Anand. So it shows the list of files which is saved in your current local working directory under the SAM server. So just click this test.php, you can see the output of your PHP script. So it is showing, see here, parse error, syntax error, unexpected in line number 3. So this is the advantages of Notepad++. We can easily find out where the error is lying. So you can easily find out the line number, in which line the error is lying. So you just go to that Notepad++ and find out what is the error. So here, this welcome to XAMPP server, I have not closed that double quotes. That is a problem here. So I am just giving it here, double quotes. So any changes you are making, file, go to the save option. Then after that, you just go back to the XAMPP server folder and refresh it. So localhost. So we use localhost. So you can have localhost, then followed by the folder name Anand. So this is the output for your PHP script. Welcome to XAMPP server, all the very best. So you can have you can include all the HTML tags in your PHP script. So you can add color, you can add all the HTML tags, all the tags you can add in, you can embed all your HTML tags inside the PHP script. Even you can add your CSS tag also inside the PHP script. So once you are executing your program, kindly stop all the server model which are running. Kindly stop Apache model. So you can see that status change is detected. That is, the Apache is stopped. Again, similarly, MySQL also, you have to stop that particular MySQL. So this is how we have to execute our PHP script using the XAMPP web server.